The Thomas Farm Fossil Site is out here in Bell in Gilchrist County. It's on 40 acres owned by the University of Florida, and for more than 50 years it's been managed by the Florida Museum of Natural History. It's the richest early Miocene site in the world. By that I mean from the early Miocene period, which is about 18 million years old, we've identified more species of amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals from Thomas Farm than any other site of its age in the world. We're up to 102 species, and it's a very important site from a research standpoint. We still have lots of ongoing research here on the fossils that we excavate, and it's also a really nice site for public education. So you'll see a lot of bags of sediment here that we excavate, and we haul up the stairs and screen wash. So by screen washing, I mean we have hoses with a sort of a shower nozzle, and we have nested sets of sieves. So they go through half inch mesh, then quarter inch mesh, then 16th inch mesh or window screen, and each size mesh catches the bones. And most of the really good stuff is actually in the 16th inch, in the really smallest size. That's where actually most of the diversity of animals is at Thomas Farm, just like it would be today in rural Florida. There are a lot more small species than there are large species. So one of the beauties of Thomas Farm, by owning the site and being able to dig here year after year, and we continue to find new species every year we dig, we're putting together sort of the whole food web as it existed 18 million years ago in North Florida.
It's really exciting. The spot that I have in particular has been really productive. I've probably pulled out over 50, 60 fossils already.
We've had a great day of digging fossils. Among the major finds is quite a few bones of the very largest species of horse here, one called Anchitherium, which is the rarest horse. Lots of bones, lots of fossils of Parahippus, the medium-sized horse, and then quite a few bones of Archaeohippus, the little horse. Excavating these fossils and then filling bags with the sediment that contain the microfossils, that's a very time-consuming effort. We don't have enough scientists at the museum, not even near enough, to do all the work ourselves. So by working side by side with these volunteers, they learn a lot, we learn a lot alongside them, of course, but also we get a lot of work done. So even though the main purpose of this dig in the spring is for public education, we're also sort of killing two birds with one stone. We're getting a lot of really high quality research done.